my name is Vibeke and welcome to Diving Ducks Crochet. Today I want to show you yet another slippers tutorial. If you want to see all my other slippers, then go ahead and check out the playlist on my channel page. So today I want to show you how to crochet these slippers, and you can do these only by following this tutorial. I will of course show you from the very beginning to the end exactly how to do this step by step. But if you prefer to follow a written pattern, I will of course leave a link for that below. These today in the video will be in a size 9. If you want other sizes, you can do it yourself, alter it. You can, if you want it to be for your husband with a huge foot, then you can just do a few more rows up here at the foot. Just measure it along the way. And if you need it to be bigger, you will just add a few more rounds at the top right here. But you can do this when you make it to that point. Yeah, let's begin. First, a little about the materials. I have actually done it with two different kinds of yarn just to try it out. I have done it with a Mega Ball from Hobi and Mega Ball Aran from Hobi. It's completely the same yarn, just the thickness is a lot bigger with the Aran kind. This is a lightweight 3 and this one is a medium weight 4. So I have tried it out. I've done one slipper in this type of yarn, so the thick one, the Aran one, and I've done the other one in double in this one. So I just took both the end from the inside and the one from the outside, put it together and crochet as if it was one of these threads. And the difference is not to be noticed. You can see I have done one in each kind and they are the same size. So you can do it both ways. So I will write down in the description how much yarn you will be needing. I have used a 5mm hook, some scissors and a tapestry needle. First we create a slip knot. And then we chain 2. So yarn over, pull through twice. Then we do a single crochet in the first chain. So insert the hook through the first chain and single crochet. Then we work another single crochet in the same stitch. So insert the hook in the same chain and work another single crochet. Repeat this until we have 8 single crochet in total. So just insert the hook in the same stitch again and again, until you have a little round of 8 single crochet. And now I have 8. Now in the next stitch, so in the first single crochet you did, you will do 2 single crochet. So insert the hook through the first stitch and do 2 single crochet in the same stitch. So 1, and then insert the hook in the same stitch again, and work another single crochet. Repeat this all the way around with 1 single crochet in the next and then another single crochet in the same stitch. So 1 single crochet and then in the same stitch another single crochet. So 2 single crochet in each stitch all the way around. When you are all the way around, you should have 16 single crochet in total. Now when you have 16 single crochet, you can weave in this end and cut it off. In the next stitch, so in this one, we will do an increase. So 2 single crochet in the same stitch. So insert the hook and work 2 single crochet in the same stitch. And then in the next stitch, we will only do 1 single crochet. Then in the next stitch, 2 single crochet. 2, and then only 1 single crochet in the next. So you will switch between 1 and 2 single crochet again and again. So in the next one you'll do 2 single crochet, then only 1 single crochet, then 2 single crochet, and so on. And you will keep doing this until you have 30 stitches in total. So keep doing 2 single crochet, 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet, just around and around in spirals. Don't worry about going through to the next round. We are going at the second round right now, on the third round, sorry, but we will just continue in spirals until we have 30 stitches in total. Now, when you have 30 stitches in the round, we will do no more increases. Now we will be working up along the foot, so just one single crochet in each stitch. And you will keep working around in spirals for 21 rounds in total. So counting from this one as your first round, then your second, your third, and you will just do one single crochet in each stitch until you have 21 rounds in total. So just continue one single crochet in the next stitch, one single crochet in the next stitch, and so on until you have 21 rounds. So when you have 21 rows or rounds, you will now chain one and then you turn the work. So now we will be working the other way. You skip your turning chain, move on to the second stitch and do a single crochet. And then do one single crochet for 21 stitches. So this is 3. We will continue until we have 21. And 21. Then we chain one and turn. Skip your turning chain, one to the second, and single crochet. So now we will be working back and forth with single crochet. So 21 stitches on each row, just work back and forth. At the end, you chain one and turn, and then you skip your turning chain and move back and forth in rows for 15 rows in total. When you have 15 rows up here, you will now begin the 16th row. So you chain one to turn, and then you turn, and then you crochet 10 single crochet. So this is the first crochet, 10 single crochet. And that's 10. So almost halfway. We have the slipper right here, and this is the right side I'm facing out. So I will now fold the slipper. And when we fold it, you know, this makes it into a slipper, but we will fold it the other way, so like this. So we are doing a seam right here on the inside instead of on the outside. So you fold the slipper like this, and then you make a seam of slip stitches through both layers all the way through. So push in the hook through both layers like this and slip stitch. And then through the next stitch through both layers and grab the yarn and slip stitch all the way through. When you finish the last one, we have now closed up the foot. So now we can turn it like this and open it up, and then we have our little slipper. Now you can use it as it is, or you can keep crocheting like I'm doing right here and add a little rib on top. So I will begin with a chain one, and then I will do one single crochet all the way around the edge. So this is the first row. I will do one single crochet into this, and then a single crochet in the next row. And then just work one single crochet all the way around. When I'm all the way around, I will finish with one slip stitch in the first single crochet I did. So insert the hook in the first single crochet and slip stitch. So just yarn over and pull through and pull through. Now we will do the rib. So we will chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So chain 15, and we will now do the ribbing. So skip the first chain, move on to the second one, and single crochet. Keep doing single crochet all the way to the bottom. So just work one single crochet in each stitch all the way to the bottom. And we chained up 15. We skipped the first one, so you should have 14 single crochet when you're at the bottom again. So, now I have 14 single crochet, and this is the first part of the ribbing. Now we will find the next stitch on the bottom, and this is the next stitch. So I will do a slip stitch in this one, and then a slip stitch in the next one. So just insert the hook in the next stitch and slip stitch. And then I will turn and then work my way up along this edge again. We will skip the two slip stitches, just pretend they doesn't exist. So this one and this one, just pretend they don't exist, and then work a back loop single crochet in the next stitch. And if you don't know what the back loop is, you know this is the entire stitch. And if you're only working through the back loop, you will work through this loop. So this is the back loop. We skip the two slip stitches. Now we insert the hook in the back loop of the next stitch and work a single crochet. And then in the next stitch, back loop, single crochet. Work your way to the top with a back loop, single crochet in each stitch. And when you're at the top, you chain one and turn. Skip your turning chain, move on to the second one, and do a back loop single crochet. Again, next stitch, back loop, single crochet. Work your way all the way to the bottom with one back loop single crochet in each stitch. And again, you will have 14 back loop single crochet. When you're at the bottom, you can see this ribbing effect coming. Now you'll find your next stitch. And remember, you already worked in this one. So this one over here is your back, is your next stitch. So work a slip stitch into this stitch. And then a slip stitch into the next. So two slip stitches at the bottom, and you can see we are pinning it down, so we are working a rib up along the edge of the sliver. Now you repeat, you turn it, and then you pretend these two slip stitches doesn't exist and move on to the third stitch where you will back loop single crochet. Oops. So skip the slip stitches and insert the hook in the back loop of the next stitch. That's it. Now work your way all the way up with one back loop single crochet in each stitch. Chain one and turn, and then work your way back and forth all the way around the sliver until you're all the way back here. And when you make it all the way around, you have this huge ribbing. Then we will connect the ends, and we will do that by crocheting a slip stitch through both layers. So just push in the hook through both layers, and then yarn over, pull through, pull through. Then again, next stitch, push in through both layers, yarn over, pull through, and we will continue like this all the way to the bottom. And when you're at the bottom, we now connected this and completed this round. Now we will grab a big amount of yarn and then cut it. And we will be needing a lot to sew the rest up. So now we will pull this hook through. And then find our tapestry needle. And then take this ribbing and fold it down like this. And you can, of course, just leave it like this and just wear it like it is right now. Or you can sew it on. So you secure it on the bottom. And I will, for each other row, I will make a little stitch down here below. So just, you know, sew like this. So the rib is staying in place. So it stays down. But that's totally optional. You can just leave it and take it up and down as you like. So I will make a seam all the way around. And finally, you weave in the end on the inside of the slipper, cut the yarn, and then you have this beautiful little slipper. So that's it. I hope you found this tutorial easy to follow. If you did, please press thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you again soon. Bye!